We had talked about having kids, and I was no longer on birth control. But the timing of when it would happen was supposed to be a lot later. It happened like that. Then the weight gain started to happen. And so I knew that I was to gain some weight, but after a while, 20, 30 pounds, my doctor then suggested that I take an early test for gestational diabetes. And at that point, I realized the concerns were more so, how can I make sure I watch what I eat better? Because I did not have that concern going in. So I'm glad that my doctor took the time to test early and didn't ignore the weight gain that was happening.
So gestational diabetes complicates about one in every 12 pregnancies in the United States. As the placenta gets larger, it produces a substance that interferes with mom's ability to really process the sugar and the glucose and get them into the cells to use it. So mom's blood sugar goes up. And the problems that arise from that then is that if mom's blood sugar is up, it sends it into the baby through the placenta. And that can cause several different issues to arise during the pregnancy. And some of the complications that can arise with moms is they have higher risks of preeclampsia, having to have a cesarean delivery, and other things that are difficulties with birth. Now, long-term for moms is really where the problems can arise, because women who develop gestational diabetes have about a 70% lifetime risk of developing type 2 diabetes. And that is really a very high risk. It's actually the number one risk factor for developing type 2 diabetes. Babies can end up growing larger. They have a little bit of a higher risk of things like birth trauma, having problems with jaundice, and having some difficulties regulating their blood sugars right after birth. Babies also that are born to women who have gestational diabetes have longer term consequences, and they have higher rates of issues with diabetes and glucose control later in life, and childhood obesity as well.
So the emotions I had when I found out I had gestational diabetes, emotional breakdown is a good phrase. I really felt like I had done something wrong, like there is something that I should have watched out for. But my doctor assured me that it was truly something that was out of my control, and I was genetically predisposed to it. And so it was something that I could just move forward in handling appropriately. And even with that conversation, the most important thing has been meeting with my doctor continuously throughout the pregnancy as life is happening and I'm preparing for this baby to make sure I stay on track.
So the IU Grand Challenge Precision Health Initiative Diabetes Project is really aimed at two activities. One is the prediction and prevention of gestational diabetes. So we're utilizing large cohorts and we're recruiting a new cohort of women to really understand how does the demographic characteristics of a woman, how do stress, anxiety, depression, how does your physical activity and your diet really impact those risks? And how does your genotype, how do the DNA blueprints of your body help us understand and potentially prevent some of these things from happening, so that we can tell a woman early in her pregnancy, this is your risk of gestational diabetes, let's figure out a way to prevent that from happening. And then in the later phase, if they did develop gestational diabetes, it's really giving them options that we can help them address in multiple ways. How can you prevent type 2 diabetes? By using the diabetes prevention program and making it within a structure that works with your family. We want to make sure that people are informed so they can be empowered to take charge of their own health.